Folks, I don't know what could be better than this. It's a beautiful morning, sky's blue, sun's shining in Colorado, and you're here watching our videos. My name's Will Warren, thanks for stopping by. Today I'm gonna walk you guys through the 2906WS Rockwood Ultralight Travel Trailer. There's a lot of features, let's get started. Now the Rockwood Ultralight, this one in particular, has three slides on it. You got a wardrobe slide, two in your living room. Rockwood is known as the number one selling fiberglass travel trailer throughout the entire United States for a few good reasons. You have excellent warranties, the construction is top notch, double welded aluminum framework throughout the entire coach, vacuum bonded sidewalls. You have a 12-year warranty on the roof, you have a 10-year warranty on the axles, you have a 1-year bumper to bumper, 2-year structure warranty, it just goes on. So I'm really excited to show you guys what's in store for this coach. All right, you guys, I want to start you off right here, this corner of the trailer. There's a lot of features, especially behind this door. But real quick, this unit does feature 4 electric stabilizer jacks. There's a switch up here for the front two and a switch at the very back for the rear. There's also a little plug right down here, and that's prepped for a solar panel. So you can plug in a portable solar panel, stick it out in the sun, and it'll charge your batteries. But let me show you this storage compartment. This is kind of a different frame than you see in a lot of travel trailers. Look at this vertical height that you have. So normally a travel trailer, the floor right here might actually be about here. But with this Rockwood, the frame is kind of dropped down low, so you get a lot of vertical storage. Now, it doesn't pass all the way through because on the other side, you have your hot water heater, you have a water pump and other things, utility features. But this still gives you a ton of storage. And remember, we talked about Rockwood having an aluminum structure to it. That's visible right here. So if you look at those joints, you can see the welds they put on the Rockwood. Yeah, right there. And those are double welded at all those joints. Just to create a stronger bond for you. Now you also happen to have in this, you have a GFCI outlet and a cable outlet. So if you wanted to buy a TV to put outside here, you can do it. They even give you a little bracket to mount it on. So you just gotta buy a bracket that puts on the back of the TV there and lay it on that. And then you can hook it up to all the hookups right here. The other thing that's nice is that this coach in this compartment features a little light on a motion sensor. So you probably couldn't see it because it is the daytime here, but when I open up this door, that light automatically kicks on so you can see what you're getting. And that's of course very helpful at nighttime. Other thing I want to point out here is the thickness of this door. So you can see that this is not just a single piece of fiberglass. They have styrofoam insulation in this, just like the styrofoam that's throughout the rest of the coach, the walls, the ceiling, and the floor. So, anyways, that is this compartment that's loaded with features. Let's continue on down. I want to point out to you guys the awning. Now you actually have 2 awnings on this coach. This is the main awning. And then over there on the slide out, you have a secondary awning. Now you can adjust these as well. So you can loosen up this right here and you can pull this down. And what that does is 2 things. One, you can adjust it for the angle of the sun. And the second thing is when it's raining, it'll kind of shed the water off this direction instead of just pooling up there in the awning fabric and weighing it down, of course. So you can stop this wherever you want just by simply tightening that nut right there. So we'll leave it, there we go, all the way in the up position. Now these Rockwood Ultralights feature frameless windows. That's really great. It kind of keeps the seals of the rubber fresher for longer instead of drying out over time. Plus they're just nicer to look at. You can pop those open in a rainstorm and not have to worry about rain getting in on the getting in from the storm. Right here, they do come with grills. So you have this RVQ grill. It plugs in directly into your propane lines, which are located right down there. There's a little yellow plug at the bottom and there's a core that comes from this control knob right here all the way down to there, and you can feed this grill directly off your propane system. There's also a little table for prep space. That's a really nice feature to have besides your grill. The door here, you notice it has the curved top. That's really important for when you want to maybe bring down one of these arms, or bring them both down depending upon the sun, because what you don't want is a sharp corner up there that's going to cut into the awning fabric. You can also see by the top of the door and by the awning, there's the LED light strip. Both awnings have these, and it really makes a nice bright area out here at nighttime for you. The door itself features a friction hinge, so this is designed to kind of stay wherever you leave it. It's also designed so that when a big gust of wind comes up, this door isn't just going to slam into the frame. You also have your screen door as well to let in light, let in air. You can completely close it off from the bugs with that right there. And if you still want to have a little extra light but you don't want the screen open, Rockwood's got you covered with a little, opaque window there to let light in. So let's close that. I want to show you, you have a triple entry step into the coach. You have a tow light, and that may seem like a small option, but that really does, of course, help you see where you're stepping at night. You have the large grab handle that easily gets out of the way for you. You can lock that in that position when you're traveling down the road. Just like that. And then on down this way, of course, we have our other awning, LED light strip that I mentioned, more frameless windows, outside speakers. So the coach has a media center on the inside, and you can play, of course, your music inside the coach, outside the coach, and you can also kill it on the inside and play it just on the outside. There's also Bluetooth capability, so if you keep all your music on your phone like I do, you can be out here by the fire pit controlling the tunes from your device without having to go in and switch things around. All right, you guys, this is the back of the 2906. A couple things I wanna point out to you. This tire cover, it may not seem like a big deal, but having a hard plastic tire cover is much better than having the soft fabric tire covers you usually see. The fabric covers work okay, but over time they begin to crack along the top here due to the sun, and you have to replace it. This, unless you end up beating it up and cracking it that way, is not going to break on you. Now, you have a ladder here to gain access to the roof for maintenance. You really don't have to go up there except to clean and condition the roof. That's going to really extend the life of that. Now, you still have a 12-year warranty, but I guarantee if you clean and condition it, it's going to last you much, much, much longer. Now, if you notice also with the roof, it has that curvature to it. So that's a radius roof is what that's called. It's radiused here on the outside, and it's also curved on the inside to give you more headroom. But that's important because it helps to shed water off the roof, and that prevents leaks, of course. Now, you also notice you have these two black spigots on each corner of the roof. And what those are designed to do, they're like gutters. So they shoot out the water away from the roof. As you can imagine, these things are sitting outside, the roof gets really dusty, and then when a big rainstorm hits, right, you have all this brown, black water running off the roof. What you don't want is you don't want black streaks down the side of your coach. So that's what that's designed to do. It's designed to kick that out and away so you don't get those nasty black streaks. Now, below those three red running lights, you notice there's that little black piece there. That's prep for a backup camera. So if you want to have an in-motion backup camera, it's really easy to do. You just buy the camera and the screen that goes with it. It just plugs in right there, and then you can have that on while you're in motion or while you're backing up. That's the other really great thing about it. You have a large window here. Now, these two panels open up to give you ventilation, which is really nice. And then lastly down here, of course, you have your bumper. Not a very exciting feature, but it does have a nifty little storage place to put a sewer hose if you want to. Keep that out of the way and out of your other storage compartments. Now, if we continue down the driver's side, I want to show you a couple things. This right here is where you would plug in your 50 amp cord. This coach is 50 amp service. Now, when you plug into this, if you're getting power from your pedestal to the coach, there's a little light on here that's going to kick on, and that way you know you have power. If it doesn't kick on and you're plugged in, now you know there's either something wrong with your cord, or perhaps maybe a breaker at the pedestal's been thrown, so you got to go there, flip that on, and you'll have power to the coach. Down here you'll see there's the those rear stabilizer jacks that were up in the front as well. Oh, and let's also talk about the slide mechanism. This is not something that I usually point out, but you see right here, this is called a ram, and that's what runs the slide in and out. A lot of guys will use a real cheap cable system to run their slides in and out. The problem with that is over time, those steel cables, they stretch and they get worn out. And you're talking about a service issue. So these are a more reliable way to do it. And they're very easily adjustable. Here, now come on this way. I want to show you this storage compartment door here. So one nice thing about the Rockwoods, they have these magnetic holders to keep your door latched in place. Of course, this is another storage area for you. So you have just whatever you want to put in here. The back of that is a, that little black box you saw there is an inside electric heater and fireplace. We'll show you later on. If you're wondering, this is the back of your fridge. And this is a little condensation tube. Of course, the condensation can drip out while it's cooling. Here you can hook up your cable and satellite. There's a radio antenna up there, another part of the fridge, and then this is your hood, your range hood vent. So when you're cooking with your range, of course you want to vent out any smoke or steam or smells. What you want to do is you want to pull down on these two tabs here, and that's going to open that to let all that stuff escape. Now there's a lot to cover right here, and if you guys have enjoyed this video, I don't know if you know this, of course you do, but YouTube channels really, it helps us out if you guys hit that like button for us. So if you enjoyed this, please consider hitting that like button, and maybe subscribe to our channel. We put out content all the time. Now down here, you have your axles, and I want to point these out because these are not your typical leaf spring axles that you have on a trailer. They're actually torsion axles. So what that means is that each wheel has independent suspension from one another. And what that does is when you're driving down an uneven road, it makes this tow even nicer. Also, they happen to have aluminum rims. Of course, those don't rust out like the steel ones do. They also are a lot lighter, and they dispense heat from the road a lot more quickly. They happen to be nitrogen filled as well, and these axles do have a 10-year warranty on them. Very, very few people are putting that robust of a warranty on their axles, but these torsion axles from Dexter are that good. Now, up here, there's a little light up there right above this little window. Now, that light is kind of nice because you also happen to have your dump station down here. Now, the dump valves, or I should say the dump elbows, and your tanks on this coach are heated with some heat pads. And I think we can get down there and probably show you. Let's see here. Yeah, right. Oh, they're not visible from here. But the tanks do have some heat pads. You can see that the whole tanks are enclosed underneath. And that, of course, is to help, keep debris and stuff from getting in there. It doesn't actually add a lot of R value, but what it does do, of course, is keep it clean, like I said, keep debris out. It might add a little bit of R value, but it keeps the tank pads and the tanks protected. So, and those tank heating pads are what really prevent it from freezing up on you. Now, right here, you have an outside shower, and it's actually nice because this one is at a good height, right? I'm 5'7", and here I am. Usually they're like way down here, but this has hot and cold water. You can shower off if you got sandy before you want to go in, or you just happen to be dirty. You want to hose off the dog or the kids. And the nice thing about it is you can set the temperature with these hot and cold knobs. And since, you know, you may not want to go through a ton of water while you're showering off real quick, you can kill the flow of water with this switch right here. And then you don't have to find the sweet spot with the temperature on these again. Now this here is just your exhaust for your furnace. And this is the black tank flush. So when you go to a dump station, you're ready to clean out your black tank, hook a hose to this, and that's gonna fill up that black tank. You're gonna pull the gate valve. It's gonna flush out, close it up, fill it up again. Maybe do that a couple times. It'll make sure that that tank doesn't get rancid on you. Okay, now follow me this way. This, of course, wardrobe slide. Right here, you're like, well, what is this right here? So this is an access panel to your water pump system and also your filtration system. So there's one screw that's just holding this panel in place. It's designed just to, you know, add a little added protection, but you remove that, and then there's a water pump you can gain access to if you need to do maintenance. Also, there's a water filter. So this coach features a 10,000 gallon water filtration system. It goes down to 0.9 microns, residential grade. And when you need to swap that out, you simply remove that panel right there, pop a new filter in, and you're good to go. This is where you fill up your water tank. So if you're gonna be camping away from hookups, you wanna fill up your water tank right here, and then you can turn on your water pump and you'll have water on board. This is for if you're camping at a campsite with a pressurized water connection like city water. You would connect it to this, connect it to the spigot, and now you have pressurized water. It completely bypasses your pump. This is one of the best features Rockwood has had for years and years and years, and very few people do it. I don't understand why, but this is an antifreeze inlet. So you can connect a hose to this and put it into your bucket of antifreeze. And what that does is it sends it throughout the whole system. So you just gotta go in and turn everything on. You still wanna bypass your hot water heater, which is very easy to do on this coach. This makes winterization a breeze. That way you don't have to connect a hose to the pump and then do all that. Now your water heater, let's talk about that real quick. Right here, it's a 6 gallon water heater. Now this recovers at a rate of 16.2 gallons per hour, which is really, really nice. That's a very quick recovery rate for a tank heater. You also happen to have electric heat on board and propane. So if you happen to be plugged in, flip it on to electric. Otherwise, put it on propane and it'll heat that way. And lastly, your docking lights right here. You can flip these on and off with this switch and this cap. Let me just talk about this cap real quick. So here you got a fiberglass cap, automotive glass window that lets in a lot of light. Down here you can see this big section of diamond plate material. Of course, when you get rock strikes maybe from your vehicle, it just happens to kick up a few rocks. This is gonna absorb that really, really well. We have our battery hooked up here. And there's a battery box for you as well. You have two 30 pound propane tanks. There's a battery disconnect switch under here as well. And what that does is when you go to store this unit, you don't necessarily want your smoke detector, propane detector, eating away at the life of your battery, because those are always on, they never shut off. Unless you disconnect, use the battery disconnect up here. And that of course extends the life of your battery. This right here is your power tongue jack. So it has a little docking light on it right here, three LEDs. And of course, just with the push of the button, you can raise or lower this. Now, if it happened to fail for you, or let's say you lost power for some reason, you can always remove this little cap right here, just like that. And there's a manual crank override. Now, weights are important when you're talking about hauling a camper. This coach dry says it's 7,435 pounds dry. So that means no gear, no water, no propane, just bare bones. Now, you have a GVWR of 8914. So you have over 1,000 pounds of cargo you can put into this. And that's a lot of cargo, let me tell you. That's a full tank of water, plus, 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 plus. So you probably will never actually get to the full GVWR of this coach, but it's nice to have the extra room. So you can rest assured that you can put all the gear in here you need and still be within the weights you want to be. All right, guys, come on in. Let me show you the inside of this coach. So those two slides, as you can see, give you a ton of space in this coach. You got this whole open floor space. So if you have pets, if you just have kids that are gonna run around, grandkids, whatever the case, on a rainy day, this is gonna suit you a lot better than a smaller enclosed coach. Now there's a lot to go over here. Let's start with the kitchen area. So here you have this nice solid surface Corian countertop. There's a little extension right here that you can put up for more space if need be. But you already have all of this. You have this cutting board that can double up your space as well. Underneath that, we have our stainless steel two compartment sink, which is nice. And of course, it's pretty deep, and you have this high-rise faucet with an adjustable nozzle, so you can really clean all your big pots and pans. Now up here, of course, you have your microwave. Oh, excuse me, whoops. There is storage, more storage down here. Underneath the sink, you can gain access to all of that. The cabinetry in a Rockwood, all the doors here you see, it's actual real maple wood. And they don't just staple their cabinets together. Everything is screwed and glued, so it's not gonna rattle apart on you when you go down the road. Now you have storage up above the range here as well. More countertop space, which is really nice to have. And even the cover to the range is flat, so you can use that as counter space if you need to. When you're ready to cook on this range, you simply fold it up like this, and you got a nice backsplash in case you're cooking something with a little bit of oil or grease. Now again, you have your, well, you have your larger LP oven right here if you're gonna be doing some baking. Four drawers, And then here's your fridge. Now again, this is also real maple wood as well on this coach. And the fridges are nicer to open. You just kind of give a little tug on them and they pop open just like that. So here you have a 6 cubic foot gas electric refrigerator. It'll run off of your liquid propane, or it'll also run off of your electrical connection if you happen to be plugged in. Now, with the kitchen on this slide right here, sometimes it's hard to put in a window. So it can get kind of dark, but Rockwood has you covered right here. So you got this nice skylight, and if it's a little too bright for you, you can always draw the shade across just like that. Now your entertainment space, let's talk about this because this is pretty exciting. You have that media center right here that's Bluetooth capable. It'll play CDs, DVDs. You can even plug in an auxiliary cable, auxiliary ports. There's a 5-volt charge center, USB port, and an HDMI in as well. You have your sound bar, and you have your 43-inch HD LED TV. Now, let me show you this real quick. This has a little release on it, right? So back here, look at all that storage you have. You could make this more pantry space. You could just put games, DVDs, whatever you want back there. But it's nice that it's just not wasted on an empty space. Of course, you have another panel down here with a lot of storage. And this is that fireplace we mentioned earlier. So it's an electric fireplace. You can turn it on with a little light show if you want, and you can leave off the heat, or you can kick on the heat and the light show, or just do the heat. And it'll make this whole area here really nice and toasty. Now, that's not, of course, your only source of heat. You have the furnace. And if you see right here and over there, there's floor registers for the heat. And that's probably going to be your main source of heating during really cold times. Now, the couch. Let's talk about this real quick. This couch does fold out into an extra bed, so you can remove these cushions right here. This is what you call a tri-fold sofa. So you lift up this bottom piece, and as you pull it out, you kind of pause to extend these two legs, and then lower it down, and you fold this right here. Now there you got a nice bed for guests. And the best thing about it is, unlike the old school inflatable air mattresses, of course, this is not gonna pop on you. So to fold it back up, we just go through the opposite procedure. Lift this up. Fold that down and replace your cushions real quick. Now the other thing I wanted to mention, of course, you have more storage up here. You can kind of see that curvature, that radius that I spoke about on the outside. So that adds a lot of height. So if you happen to be taller than me and I'm only 5'7", you know, you're not going to be whacking your head on everything here, including, you know, these AC registers, which there's always two when there's a AC register. It has a sister unit right beside it. Your LED lights throughout the entire coach are kind of a pancake shape, so you're not going to be whacking your noggin on that. The only thing that even really sticks out is just your smoke detector. Now also, you have GFCI outlets on either side of the couch. And that's really great because more than likely you got a device, or you have 5 devices even. So there's usually a big need for charging. There's a lot of outlets throughout this entire living room area. Now the windows, let's talk about the windows. So usually manufacturers, they'll kind of skimp on it. They'll try to save some money by leaving out windows on the sides right here, right? You'll just have a big back window. But these ones here do open up, and they have what's called a day-night shade. So this is what you call the night shade. It's a little darker, doesn't let in quite as much light. There's your day shade, it's more of a sheer material. And you can open that up to get to the window. Now if you want to get some ventilation, you simply twist this knob here, and that window opens up. And you can do the same thing with this window on that window and on these two windows right here. And this lets in quite a bit of light when you open up all these blinds. Okay, let's talk about these chairs over here. So these are the new chairs from Rockwood. They're reclining chairs. You also happen to have this little table as well. So if you wanna have your craft brew, or you wanna have your margarita or your gin and tonic, nice spot for that. And if you wanna get rid of it, you simply pull it up and put it out of the way. They also happen to feature massage, heat, and a light for your cup right here, a little blue light that lights up. And when you're ready to recline, there's a little handle here. Pull up on that. And as you can see, as I lean back, my legs scoot forward. That's so that you don't end up whacking the back of this against the wall. Now your dinette can easily seat four people around it. These chairs are held in place by a strap that kind of wraps around the legs and wraps around the post in the middle. But let's say you had an extra guest or you just needed a little extra table room. Right here, there's a little extension. So you lift this up and then underneath in the middle, there's a little metal hook that you grab onto and you pull forward and that latches that in place. So if you have just a need for a little more room for food, or you do have an extra person either for cards. Oh, speaking of cards, we play a lot of games at my house. And so having some storage for cards or games is great. Each of these seats lifts up to give you just a little extra. Now let's go this way. I want to show you guys the control panel. So there's actually a couple to show you real quick. This controls both your AC and it controls your furnace. So you can just tell it which one you want to run. And then the AC is right up above us here. So that's your main AC. Now this unit will of course distribute air along the ductwork, kind of like we showed earlier. But if it's really hot in here, right? It happens to be like 90 degrees outside. It's like 98 in here. And you want to cool it off real quick. Well, you open up these. All right, that's closed. You would leave this open like that. That's called the quick cool feature. So it's designed to dump all the air in here real quick, kind of cool it off in a hurry. And then you can shut these and it'll distribute the air, you know, throughout the coach evenly and maintain that temperature for you. Okay, now come over here. This is your control panel. So everything is centrally located right here. You have your switch for your water heater if you want it to go on electric. If you want it to be on gas, you just switch this one here. If you want to turn on your water pump or your tank heaters, you do that right there. Tank heaters are 12 volts, so they'll run off your battery. But anything that's kind of heating off of electric tends to use a lot of energy. So if you flip this on, you may want to be plugged in, or you may want to really charge up your batteries after a night of heating your tanks. Now this right here will display your gray, black, fresh water, how full they are, and also your battery. Right now we're on 2/3 battery power. And then here controls all your slide outs. So slide out 1, 2, and 3. 1 is the kitchen slide, 2 is the living room slide, 3 is your wardrobe slide. Here you can also extend both awnings. You can turn on and off the interior lights. You can turn on your porch light. You can turn on both awning lights on the outside. And this is the other thing I wanted to mention to you right here. This is equipped with what's called a Wi-Fi Ranger. So this unit, well, a lot of campsites typically have wireless that you can, once you go and you pay to camp there, you gain access to their wireless network. Now sometimes the signal may not be that great in the campsite. So that's where this Ranger comes in. Essentially, it takes that signal it gets from the campsite and it amplifies it here right at your camper, so you're guaranteed to get a good internet signal. And you can also change the name of your wireless network that's being broadcast from the camper. You can change the password. That way nobody can war drive or nobody can use your internet connection here at the coach for their own purposes. And now up above too, I also want to show you this. This is your Winegard radio antenna. So I'm rotating it here. It's a HD digital channel TV antenna, and whatever channels are in the area, this will pick up for you. And the reason you can rotate it is, of course, sometimes you might need to adjust the antenna to get a little bit of a better signal. Okay, now let's talk about the bathroom. You guys ready? Let's go to the throne room here. Okay, so of course you have your toilet, large sink basin, countertop space, medicine cabinet. You have your radius shower right here. There's a skylight in case you're taller so you don't whack your noggin. There's also, this is that grill that we were showing you earlier. And you can close this up. There's a little magnetic strip. So when you're on the inside of it, right, it'll stay closed for you. Now when you're ready to travel, you simply pull this latch over. And once you hear it click, you're good to go. That way, these won't accidentally open on you when you're in transit. Now up above is your fantastic fan. So this fan here moves 920 cubic feet of air per minute. So So it acts like an attic fan, like a whole house fan. You flip that on in the highest setting and it's moving that much air, it'll cycle the air out of here. And also that's a really great way to cool down, especially if you happen to have cooler air outside. Now your light switch on this in the bathroom is right here. So you can flip it on and off. You'll have a little scrubby storage, or I suppose actually in the bathroom, you can use that as toothbrush storage maybe, or toothpaste. You have a spot for your toothbrushes right here, soap as well. More storage down below. They try to give you everything that they can in this coach, and a GFCI outlet. Now, this is what you call a Jack and Jill bathroom, meaning my cameraman is out here in the hallway, and this is the entrance to the bathroom from the bedroom. He's gonna go through the hallway to the bedroom. A little bit of a tight fit with that giant rig on him. But here we are in the bedroom of the 2906. Okay, I wanted to show you real quick. You do have a door from the bedroom to the bathroom. It's a sliding pocket door right here. There's also a little magnet right here to hold it in place. So you can close it like that and it kind of latches for you. Now, right behind me, you'll notice your very, very large wardrobe slide. So this extends all the way into the bathroom. And you can see there's spots for linens, towels. Here you have, look at all that cabinet space right there. Tons of room for all of your clothes, even your shoes. Hanging space right here. And if that wasn't enough storage for you, you also have storage above the bed. You have a nightstand on each side with a drawer. You also happen to have GFCI outlets again on each side, and there's a 12-volt charge center right here too. So if you want to just plug in your phone to that USB outlet, you can do that. And then the bed here is a Serta mattress, not a Serta mattress. So a nice innerspring mattress for you. And you can lift this up and you have even more storage. So this would be a good spot for your bed sheets, and here's that aluminum framework we were showing you earlier. They do that, they even frame out all of their furniture in aluminum, and you have three drawers underneath as well. Now, let me also mention to you, this right here is a vent, but you can, if you want to, since this coach has 50 amp service, you can remove that vent and put in a second AC. Now, typically in Colorado, we don't have to worry about a second AC unit. We're typically worried about keeping the coaches warm. But if you want to take this thing down to, well, you probably don't want to go down to Texas now. So say you want to go down to California, right? You can install a second AC to keep it nice and cool. There's also, I wanted to point out that window again, and let's actually open that up real quick. So here, again, the day shade. So there's that window in the front. And sometimes that's gonna be your best view. And it's nice because it makes the bedroom nice and bright. There's also another window directly behind the cameraman. And I don't know if he's gonna turn and show it to you. Okay, there you go. He kind of looks like a metal crab with this gigantic thing on his shoulders that he has videotaping me right now. But that's besides the point. Right here, if you want to have a TV in your bedroom, which, come on guys, you really don't want a TV in your bedroom, you're camping, right? But if you really have to, you can mount the TV here to the backer. There's another outlet to plug into. You have satellite right here, cable right here, and then your light switch, and also that AC that I was talking about. They've already prepped it for the sensor to go right here. That way you can have dual zones. You can have one zone for the bedroom, you can have one zone for the living room area. Thank you guys for watching our video on the 2906. We really do enjoy making these videos for you, and we really hope that you like them as well. And if you did, please remember, hit that like button, subscribe. I know you hear this from every YouTuber out there, but it does help out our channel, and we wanna keep putting out quality content for you. If you have a question, leave a comment for us. We do respond to our comment questions. And if you want to talk a little more in depth about this unit or any others you've seen on our website, which is www.thegreatoutdoorsrv.com, or through our videos, you can always give us a call. Our number is 970-313-4337. My name's Will. You can ask for me. I'm the sales manager here. You can also ask for Ryan, Tom, Gary. You can even ask for Mate. You can ask for anybody. We're all pretty knowledgeable and we're ready to help you out. Thank you for watching, you guys. We'll see you next time.